My name is Nicole. I'm 26 years old. I'm a single parent. I live in Detroit, Michigan. And I'm addicted to eating drywall. I am literally eating my house.
Nicole has been addicted to eating drywall for over 7 years. It started innocently with a bite of chalk.
I switched from chalk to drywall because drywall tastes better than chalk to me.
Now Nicole ingests drywall up to 6 times a day.
I love the smell of drywall, the texture of it, the taste. I love everything about drywall. It's kind of like a chalky taste, and I probably eat about this much a day. I get drywall wherever I can find it. My house, for instance, my friend's house, and sometimes my grandmother's house. This is the hole in my wall that I've created by picking, and I've been picking at it for like 2 months. I take a piece like this and I take it and I break it. Then I'll take a bite out of it. There are different kind of drywall. Some are thicker than others. Some just, they don't taste the same. For instance, the green drywall over there, that one has a nasty taste over there, and this one just had like a fresher taste to me.
Nicole's addiction spiraled out of control when her mother died 5 years ago.
The loss of my sister, it's been very, very hard on Nikki. She's trying to stand strong, but it does really bite her.
No one in my life knows about my addiction to drywall. It's very weird and has made me embarrassed, and I am ashamed because it's not food. I am worried that I will eventually get sick, but at this point, I do not really want to know what's in drywall.
It would break me down terribly if anything was to ever happen to Nicole. She's like a daughter to me.
My addiction is at its worst. It's really time for me to stop, but I'm not sure that I can stop.
Nicole's family doesn't know about her addiction. Today, she's finally ready to reveal her secret to her uncle.
So this is it. This is that little problem you told
me
about.
Yeah, that's the little hole I've been telling.
Yeah, so how the heck that happened?
Well, for the past 7 years, I have been eating drywall.
Eating drywall? Are you serious?
Yes.
This is not some kind of joke.
No joke.
That's an unnatural aging, not meant to go in our physical body. As you ingest this, you're also ingesting all kind of chemicals.
Mm-hmm. I know I shouldn't be eating it, but it's addictive, you know?
Yeah.
I crave it. It's getting to the point where, you know, I'm eating it too much.
7 years is a lot of poison. All right.
It feels good to have somebody to, you know, turn to, and to have somebody like him that I could possibly lean on is a great feeling.
We've got to get you to see a doctor. And I'm with you, as always, on everything. We know we're going to get past it. I know Nicole is a strong person. And I know with the right help that she can beat this.
I feel like a huge weight has been lifted off my shoulders. I'm going to take this advice, and I'm going to see a doctor and get help with my addiction. It's scary to find out what's in drywall, what I may have done to my body.
Have you had any problems with belly pain or nausea, vomiting, constipation?
I've had like stomach pain, but I've always thought that it was because of spicy foods.
Mm-hmm. And in terms of the, you know, when you have a craving for it, do you feel any kind of anxiety around that at all, anxious at all before you eat a piece of drywall?
Very anxious to eat a piece.
Yeah, you feel anxious.
Yes, okay. Very anxious.
Okay, and then once you have a piece, does the anxiety decrease, do you think?
Yes, it decreases, and I feel much better once I eat it. My craving has been satisfied.
Okay. And have you had any other issues around eating drywall? You know, for instance, has your family said anything to you or any concerns about your family or anybody else?
My family does not know. Mm-hmm. I've been hiding and keeping this for 7 years from everyone.
Okay, all right. And in terms of your past medical history, have you had any medical problems at all?
Low iron. Anemia.
Mm-hmm. And have you had any problems with feeling fatigued or dizzy or lightheaded or anything like that?
Yes, I have been feeling like fatigued sometimes and lightheaded, but I just thought that was poor eating.
All right. Well, I'm going to do a brief exam, if that's okay with you.
That's fine.
Okay.
I just feel a little pressure right here.
Right in here?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let me have you sit straight up, okay?
Okay.
One serious thing that can happen when you're eating drywall is that your intestines can get blocked. And if your intestines get blocked, that can be very serious.
Okay.
Are you aware of what makes up drywall at all, by any chance?
No, I don't know what's in drywall.
There can be glass.
Glass?
Yeah, glass. Mm-hmm. Many of these drywall compounds can have boric acid.
Isn't that like poison?
Yeah, it's very toxic to humans. And there can be other toxic compounds that are poisonous to humans and even cause cancer later on.
That's really bad.
Yeah, yeah. The good news is you're not having any symptoms that would suggest that you have any damage right now, but if it keeps going, it certainly could.
Wow. Now that I know what's in drywall and all the things that it could do to me, it was a real wake-up call. I want to be there for my son, to see him grow up. I don't want to get sick knowing that I could have prevented it. It's going to be very hard, but by the end of this month, I want to be drywall free.